Hello, I'm the Media Wiz, because one art form wasn't enough. Let's talk about Sitting Ducks. Sitting Ducks was one of the earliest CGI shows to be aired on Cartoon Network. It was based on a series of lithograph, created by an artist by the name of Michael Bedard in the late 70s. It was reborn as a picture book in 1998, and eventually it was turned into a TV show in 2001. While it was aired on Cartoon Network, you might be surprised as to who put it together. It was made by Universal Animation and Creative Capers Entertainment. They've had a hand in various animated movies, shows, and video games. Some good and some not so good. Like a lot of other shortly lived 2000 shows, it seems this show is being rediscovered by the internet and is given props for its funny writing, characters, top-notch voice cast, and effectively simplistic animation. The plot to the show is very basic. It's a world of cartoon animals, and you got a civilization of ducks who are at odds with a civilization of alligators, and the two main characters are an odd couple of friends, a good-natured duck named Bill and a goofball alligator named Aldo, and from there, wackiness happens! Despite the show lasting only two seasons, it seems to have garnered an audience. Years later, the series has been rerun a couple times on other networks, and the entire show is now viewable on Peacock. And while not a financial breakthrough in the States, it did surprisingly well in Europe, garnering reprints of the art and the book, toys, t-shirts, home video releases on VHS and DVD, and of course today's subject, video games. As far as I can tell, this show got two video games made in its name. The first was for PlayStation 1 and Game Boy Advance, and the other was released for PlayStation 2 and Windows. I was going to review the Game Boy Advance game, but I sadly didn't get it in time for this review. I was even thinking about comparing and contrasting that game versus this one, but what you gonna do? Maybe some other time. Released in 2004, the PS2 Windows game was put out by Universal, as well as Light and Shadow Productions and Asobo Studios. Both companies have put out tie-in games for animated shows and movies. As far as I can tell, LSP hasn't done anything since 2005, but Asobo, on the other hand, is still going. And what's really funny, this was their second game they ever made. While the Sitting Ducks TV show seems to have gotten a lot of good feedback all these years later, the same kind of sentiments cannot be said for the game. But let's see for ourselves. This is Sitting Ducks on PC. Well, right off the bat, the graphics actually look pretty good. Nothing great by any means, but it looks as good as the original show. Color me surprised. After all these games that have tried to turn characters into uncanny 3D, this one actually managed to look passable. So what's the story here? We have a world of human-like ducks, and thankfully none of them are teleported to the Earth in the 1980s, or show creepy humanoid duck breasts, so already we're on the right track. We're introduced to one of our two main characters, Bill, a mild-mannered duck who enjoys reading and helping his friends any way he can. He also owns a pet parrot, despite the fact that, you know, he's a duck. And, you know, it's weird for animals to own other animals as pets. It's kind of like the whole Goofy Pluto debate. You really don't want to think about it too hard. It'll send you to some really dark and creepy places. Anyway, he leaves his apartment for the day, and we're thrust into the world of Ducktown. Get used to this overworld, you'll be seeing it a lot. The world basically serves as a ton of side missions and venues that lead into levels all throughout the game. Before we get to the gameplay proper, I just want to mention the NPCs really quick. There are several times where you can spot background characters driving on the sidewalks, crashing into each other, hitting characters and speeding off, and appearing out of thin air. And it doesn't help that the roads in this town don't seem to have any dividing lines that separate lanes on the roads. This town's traffic laws are about as safe as putting an actual duck behind the wheel of a vehicle in real life. The hit damage is also really confusing in this game. Sometimes you'll get hit by something and barely take damage, but other times you barely get hit by something and take a lot of damage. It's incredibly inconsistent, and it happens very frequently. But back to the story. It's important for Bill to meet up with his friends, who want him to join them at a milkshake diner to watch the new hit show, Running Ducks. If you're familiar with the show, this should seem familiar, since it's taken from the very first episode of the series. And in fact, they actually took a lot of elements from episodes of the show and tried to implement it into the game. This leads to the first mission, if you want to call it that. You have to follow these guys to this diner while riding on a skateboard that they gave you. There are plenty of other levels that involve missions like this, like an obligatory racing stage where you have to beat someone in a race. The skateboard controls aren't the worst I've ever played, but oh my god, is it easy to crash into things, what with all the AI background duck characters wandering the streets. As you make it to the diner, the ducks finish watching the TV and quickly leave at the thought of predators wandering into Ducktown that night. But silly old Bill isn't paying attention to any of that.
A duck was attacked by an alligator last night, not too far away from here.
You know, I think people are watching too much TV around here.
If he thinks that TV is loaded with garbage, just wait until he discovers the internet. As Bill wanders home, he ends up getting chased by a big bad alligator. This results in a mission, if you even want to call it that. It's actually a key problem with a lot of the gameplay that's in this. All the stages where you're actually able to do something feels incredibly short or really uneventful. So after, like, 2 seconds of trying to get away from the alligator, it's followed by a cutscene of Bill being cornered, but he manages to give the gator the slip after the gator hits his head and gets a toothache. But then these two begin to hit it off and become instant best friends.
Just go away and leave me alone. I'm in pain.
Yeah, well, you better be a little more careful. I may not be so nice next time.
What? Me be careful?
Bill lets Aldo stay at his house for the night, and the next day, Bill has to figure out how they're going to make this work, what with ducks and alligators being at odds with each other. Now they're taking elements from the original book, since that kind of thing happens there too. Back to the town overworld, where we get a mission to collect aspirin, a duck mask, and ice cubes. And then after that, you have to collect as much ice cream as possible. After a while, it feels like you're just running around in a circle. You could run in this stage, but it's considerably easier to use the skateboard. And instead of putting interesting obstacles in your path, the game continues its tradition of spamming background characters to constantly get in your way. This kind of thing happens a lot in these missions that take place in the setting. At first, I thought this was just a problem with playing this on a computer, but according to a lot of the written reviews for the PS2 version, it seems this is just a problem that both versions of the game had.
Fang! Cute.
Hey, no problem.
Okay, I guess we're done with that now. So now that Aldo has that duck mask, which, yes, does fool the duck people in this world, it's one of those kind of shows, the next stage involves having to guide him to a dentist so he can get his toothache fixed.
But I can't see anything under this mask.
In the following stage, he's able to follow you, so is it really that hard to see out of that? Whatever, it's the next mission apparently. And the thing that will be slowing you down all throughout this stage is Aldo himself. It's one of those stages where you have to stay in front of a character and they follow you the whole time, and if you lose them, they end up getting stuck behind a tree or running into a wall or something like that. So you're going to have to stop every few steps to make sure you don't lose Aldo. The other thing with missions like this is they're not very long. At all. They're incredibly short. So far, this game feels like it's had more cutscenes than gameplay. And it's not even that the stages are that difficult. If anything, it feels like you're trying to fight the wonky controls more than any of the characters on screen. So, you successfully get Aldo to the dentist, and he gives us a power-up.
Please take this little gift as my thanks to you. An elixir of vitamins that I've just invented.
Okay, but then what?
Trust me, drink it. Well, Bill, you'll be able to jump high and far.
Finally, an item that's not just another vehicle you can barely operate.
Okay, Aldo, remove the mask.
What a race!
My scooter!
By the way, the next mission is that racing level I mentioned earlier, in which you have to chase after a scooter with the skateboard that you can barely operate.
You're okay, except for that bump.
A bump? Where?
We better have this checked at the hospital.
Hospital?
Oh no, I'm going to die!
Well, Bill can't take him to the hospital because... herpity derp, Aldo leads him to the hospital instead. You get another lead character to set location before a clock runs out stage. Only difference here is that you're playing as Aldo instead of Bill. Other than that, it's the exact same gameplay. It was at this point in the game that I just decided to stop playing. It's not because it was frustrating like other games I've reviewed, like George of the Jungle on the Wii or March of the Penguins on Game Boy Advance. It's just because the gameplay really didn't seem to be going anywhere. I've looked at plenty of minigame collections before, but they usually had a sense of scale. Each minigame felt like it was pushing the game's story forward. This just feels like it's meandering around from one 2-second mission to another 2-second mission. It's not because the game is terrible, it's just that it's not that engaging. I looked up gameplay footage for later levels, and while it seems like they added some new locations as the game progresses, it just looked like it was more of the same. And apparently this game's not even that long. The few speedrunners who played this game beat it under an hour. I really wanted to give this game a chance. The graphics weren't that bad, and it started decently, but after playing through some of it, there just wasn't enough to keep me interested. Even games like Looney Tunes Back in Action and Powerpuff Girls Relish Rampage had enough in them to keep my interest and made me want to finish them. There's just nothing like that here. Far from the worst game I've ever reviewed, but at the end of the day, there just really wasn't that much to this game. And keep in mind, this was just the ROM version of the PC game. I'd hate to see how this game actually played on a PlayStation 2, let alone the PlayStation 1 Game Boy Advance game based on this show. Something tells me I'm gonna end up talking about that for a video someday in the future. But until then, I'm the Media Wiz, because one art form wasn't enough.
Dinner is ready.
Fuck, duck. I prefer chicken. This feathered fuck just sits on Twitter with a picture of a duck every minute. Oh, it's the same picture posted every time. It's just slightly different. Yes, how original. Subs up in the six figures and this pigeon still petitions others for his video. Isn't it kind of sad that you had to ask? Because you lack talent and apparently you're too embarrassed.
Quack.
You just got wrecked by an aristocrat. A 77-year-old man. What a joke. Still don't even know why you wanted me to roast. That was fucking delicious. Eggs on toast. Bitch!
Okay, I'm leaving now.
But when will you be back?
I don't know. What do you normally do when I'm gone?
Wait for you to get back.